The IGP has directed the Director General CID to take over investigation into the armed robbery incident that happened at Jamestown, the attack on a bullion van which led to the death of a police officer. Preliminary investigation shows that around 11 a.m. of Monday, while the Montran bullion van was on its daily errand, it was attacked by a number of armed men on a number of motorbikes. They aimed directly at the police officer and shot at him, killing him instantly. And then they started shooting sporadically to scare away people. So while two of them were shooting, the others went to the bullion van to break the padlock and to carry away an unspecified amount of money. By the time we finish investigating, we'll probably know how much was stolen. And they also took along with them the AK-47 rifle of the police officer. In the course of the robbery, they also murdered a hawker who was selling nearby, because the two lady or female attendants on the van, one of them got down and ran towards that direction. And so the shot went that direction. And unfortunately, they killed the civilian hawker. We are appealing to the public. We know that there were eyewitnesses. We are appealing to the public to support our investigation, give us information so that we can arrest the perpetrators as soon as possible for them to face the consequence of the law. We have put out phone numbers. One of the phone numbers, 026-212-2086. We also have 02449945640. 02442800001. Call the police. These numbers will go directly to the investigative team. You also know the police emergency numbers, 191 or 18555, for us to arrest these perpetrators as early as possible for them to face prosecution. So IGP Mr. Pombueno has also been meeting with key stakeholders who we give direct service to, and one of such stakeholders has been the Association of Bankers, and in collaboration with the Bank of Ghana. And so sometime earlier this year, it was agreed between them that by the end of this month, they would provide fortified armored bullion vans for police escorts. And so the IGP is also holding them to that agreement or that promise they made, so that our officers will also work in safe environments.